Watch this, read.
For as we have many members in one body.
We have many members for one body. Read.
And all members have not the same office.
Uh-huh.
So we being many are one body in Christ, and every one members one of another. Having then gifts differing according to the grace that is given to us, whether prophecy, let us prophesy.
Did you read verse 4 or you ran past that?
I read.
What did that say?
It says, for as we have many members in one body, and all members have not the same office.
Okay, read.
So we, being many, are one body in Christ, and everyone members one of another.
Read the book, David.
Having then gifts differing according to the grace that is given to us, whether prophecy, let us prophesy according to the proportion of faith or ministry.
Maybe you skipped the verse I'm looking for that deals with no let a man think more highly. That's 3? David, go back to 3.
For I say, through the grace given unto me, to every man that is among you,
to all of us, listen to this, read,
not to think of himself more highly.
Stop thinking you up here when everybody know you down here. Ain't nobody impressed by your press but you.
All right.
But if you want to get her, get her. Well, God said, I would exhort them that are humble, but I bring down to them that exhort themselves. We live in a day that everybody want to be at the top, but don't nobody want to be at the bottom. But the bottom will get you to the top. You got to humble yourself at the mighty hand of God. Especially when you get saved. Because when you get saved, you're excited. And the first thing you want to do is grab a briefcase. God called me. Yes, he did. He called you into salvation. Now humble yourself so you can be taught by him. Now, if I'm preaching how you would get a new wife, a new car, a new this, and a new that, you're going to get none of that. We ain't going to get none of that till we die to ourselves. Till we die to ourselves. How long is it going to take for us to realize that I don't care? Because every time you get in a new relationship, don't it just seem like it's the best thing that ever happened to you? Huh? Oh, she the one. I never met nobody like him. That's a true statement. You just don't know him yet. Huh? Then you find yourself going from relationship to relationship, bombs to bombs, loose to loose, till you make up your mind that, God, I can't make the right choices. I can't even make the right choices for my life. I'm going to humble myself and be led by you. You told me to trust. Come on, help me on that organ now. I feel a preach coming up. He said, trust in the Lord. Understand in all of your ways. Acknowledge God. Your help. I need your strength. I need your so I could just lay in his chest. Well, Susie just got through laying in his chest last night. But you could go to God and say, God, I'm gonna just tell you.
Come on.
I'm gonna stop a faking and make people think I'm what I'm not. But I'm gonna humble myself and say, God, I need your help. God, I'm gonna say, you know that the preacher that you're trying to resist and all that, he the very one I sent to you. Because you don't need a lot of sugar in you. You need somebody that's gonna stand up and tell you flat footed. You need a change. When you go through the burn through, your stuff stink too. On it and you cover it up with all this sweet stuff, but it still stinks. You need somebody to tell you that God wants to use you greatly, but he won't use you doing it your way. You got man food, but you don't have God food. I say my thoughts are not your thoughts. Neither are my ways your ways. As far as the heaven is from the earth, that's how far my thought is from your thoughts. Of God, but Moses knew his way. Pastor Moses, I thank God for you. I thank God for the circle of faith. But I'm a man that I have to get intimate. And we get strict. Iron sharpening iron. But if that was my only prayer life, I would be pitiful. Because when you really go through a situation, you need to shut everybody else out so you can hear the voice of God. I said, so you can hear the voice of God. You don't understand what I'm saying. You'll get there. You'll get there in life that nobody can keep your mind but God. And I love my wife. We pray together sometimes, but she know I like my intimate time with God. I like my intimate time with her.
Did I
get a little bit happy on that? Thank God if you have a good, powerful church. Amen. And get yourself planted so you can grow.
Yes.
You keep plucking yourself. See, you pluck yourself out every time you miss. Because God got something to say. Let me tell you something. In my closing, if you want that the devil could make you back up because he put trouble in your life, just look for another trouble, a lot of trouble. Because he know you wimpy.
All right.
You got to get to the place when all hell coming in your life. You got to get, like Paul said, listen here, having done all to stand, don't you back up, you just stand. Then I want you to have truth as you stand. Then your thoughts go crazy. Put on the helmet of salvation. So when crazy thoughts come, say, listen here, I recognize you, Satan. I cast out every thought and every thing I can do that I think. I enjoy yourself against the power of God. I bring it into captivity every thought to all the people of God. Say that I'm a more than a conqueror. Your kids doing this and that. Guess what? I trained them. They grown now, whatever they do. I'm standing walking by faith and not by sight. God had a brick wall for me. He got a brick wall for them too. Have you on this TV real good. What you like watching, baby, on TV? She said movies. Thanks for the help, baby. It was some station you used to always watch.
Lifetime.
Baby, you used to wear the move, stuff you used to watch. Lifetime. Let me tell you something. Lifetime will be good if God say pray. And you still be watching Lifetime? Then you get that phone call. There's just been a tragedy. Guess what? You'll crawl to your knees. Yes. Let me tell you something. I woke up the other day, my left side of my face swelled up, big, so big. Guess what? I started to go tell my wife, I said, no, she ain't my help. I mean, she is my help, but she can't deliver me. So I went in my office at home. I said, Lord, in the name of Jesus, by your stripes, you say, I'm healed. Yeah. God, you bore my sickness in your own body. And I'm being dead to sin and live unto righteousness. By your stripes, I'm healed. I got on my knees, went look, and said, it didn't look like it's chained, but I said, I'm healed. I've been on about my day. Sun is shining. So when the storm comes, I got some strength. Are y'all ready? Look at your name and say, listen here.
Listen here.
I'm getting in church.
I'm
gonna find what God called for me to do.
I'm
stopped in a bench member.
I'm gonna
get busy for God. My problem become his problem.
I'm
doing his will.
And
if I do his will, all this stuff he'll take care of. Give God a great big hand to God. And in my closing, the greatest thing I love about this church is, by this shall all men know you're my disciples, that you have love one to the other.
Amen.
The love in this church is incredible. Don't you let the enemy fool you out.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen?
Give God a hand clap. Come on, let's give God a hand of praise.